currently living in an era of BCP. This is the start of a new normal. So we are going to experience, work from home has actually shifted the whole paradigm. We as a security, IT security personnel used to think about the security. It has shifted. We held the model, the triangle of CIA to close to our heart in the same order, confidentiality, integrity, and availability, which we see that during the initial days when the lockdown was activated, the entire triangle was inverted. So everybody, you know, huddled together and they started putting it first availability, second integrity, and third confidentiality. IT community has put together the best hands and they have come out of that initial days wherein the AIC was getting a norm, and we have started focusing on the window of threat vector which hackers are going to exploit, and they are very, very meticulously trying. Let me tell you, at this time you have seen very recently tremendous amount of hits coming in from certain countries. We have a malware, a very potent malware like Maze, that has been unleashed. Apart from brute force, this also, you know, actually uses other windows, other aspects of the system. So IT community has been quick to react and become proactive in blocking these attempts. And I would like to attribute it partially to the benefit of the flexibility of work from home. Initially, the focus, the entire industry, may it be information security or OT security. IT and OT security was completely built upon the parametric security. A certain small chunk, I would say, was on data or the mobility security kind of stuff. So now the paradigm is shifting from parametric security to building the security around the data. So data, wherever it is, second, from how it is transmitted, and third, where it is transacted. So these are the three places at which we need to look upon as the data. There are two places to, you know, avenues to hit upon the security aspect. One is the user end, who are at, they're operating from the home currently. Other is the IT infrastructure, where your largest chunk of servers, your application, your ERP is running, may it be on cloud, may it be on, you know, on-prem. So, you know, the user awareness, as a CIO of the organization, I'm extremely thrilled and pleased when somebody in my organization comes and writes to me or calls me and say that, see, I've received this mail, it looks suspicious. So that I feel is the success which my team is doing, you know, day and night. They're working on campaigning, they're working on the awareness program. So that is the measure, one of the measures of the success, that people come up to you. As Ashish said, that people have very quickly embraced the digital transformation, never ever seen before, and it's a golden opportunity for IT. Now, you know, user awareness program is one of the things which has to be the paramount in the policy of security, IT security. There has to be constant awareness programs against phishing. People like us, we have been issuing advisories to our teams and extended teams that these are the links. Be wary of the tiny URLs. In fact, I wrote yesterday as well, you know, that those bit.ly kind of thing, because you don't know where it leads to. Threats basically remained the same, but the vector and magnitude has changed. Now there is a need to protect from outside threat as well as, you know, internal threat has always been there. So nothing has changed, but only the security paradigm has shifted. It will be helpful to have advanced threat protection. It will be, make employees aware of the phishing risk, donation scams. There has to be also regular patch management, especially on the collaboration tool. Like to Zoom, we have very recently seen there has been a lot of, UNC path injection and all those things have come up. So those collaboration tool and other tool has to be patched up regularly, backups and enabling two-factor or multi-factor authentications. And not to forget, while entire organization is operating from home, including IT personnel, but please remember there is a data center sitting out there. Please ensure that data center parameters are maintained, the temperature is maintained, the parametric security, the peripheral security, all those things are still of paramount importance. But yes, the IT policies have to be spun around the data, those three aspects of data which I earlier talked about, and the parametric security takes up slightly backseat. Given the trend of the epidemic which we are currently on and the demonstrated productivity during the work from home which we have seen recently, especially in the support functions and ITS industry, I could not agree more that work from home is there to stay. as we have seen today with the TCS announcement, it reaffirms my belief that it is here to stay, initially due to compulsion and then as a way of increasing the productivity. There is a large chunk of time of CISO and IT admins which is getting consumed into doing manual activity of patch management, configuration management, data protection, awareness campaigns, blocking of ports, spammer IDs, IP addresses, and nowadays, you know, MD5 hashes, which are, you know, suspicious hashes, keeping an eye on the security events as it unfolds. You know, you have to keep an eye on to different forums, different sites, different advisories, like a cyber threat intelligence. So you have to gather that. So for the sustained cyber security, in case of work from home becoming a norm going forward, it would no longer be a manual domain for a medium to large enterprise. Because of the bandwidth consumed, it gives a lot of stress on the system to keep yourself updated to that level, to that extent, seeing, you know, even monitoring the behavioral pattern, traffic transaction through the user computer, which is getting worked upon from home. So thus, there is a definitely a need of automating the cybersecurity front, because, you know, home is now the new office. So it is going to be here. We have seen that, you know, there is a tremendous increase on MS Teams user. Google Hangout is 25 times higher. Zoom has crossed $35 billion in share pricing and all. I'm talking about the collaborative tools because it gives us a slight, you know, idea about how and to the extent it is getting used. If we come to a avenue of the cybersecurity, you know, automation, we already have analytical algorithms which we are using very actively for prescriptive, suggestive and predictive analytics. But as of now, in the domain of information security, we have not done to a larger extent. It has started now. We, in fact, as an organization are working with our partners in security to do that. So, see, the inputs, we can have an algorithm, the analytical algorithm, which sits in the core. It listens to the cyber threat intelligence on all across the globe or the hits which your firewall is taking on the external IPs. Maybe from the vector has increased from certain CIS and China countries, like, you know, these days there's a tremendous amount of increase, brute force attack, it which is, you know, attempted on you, but it does not get through. Then the DDoS attack. So for me, these are all the inputs onto the core system, the core analytical algorithm that is happening. So what that algorithm should do as a part of automation, because if you think, it is pretty exhaustive for 2, 3, 10, 15, 20 people sitting and doing it manually. There are definitely chances of error. And then with this analytical algorithm should, as an output, give me cyber threat vector that is applicable to me with its severity, change management of internal demands and its implication. Then it should give in a controlled, you know, applicable scenarios of patching and blocking. All the patches, including SAP notes and patches, all of them are not applicable to me. But here I'm talking about the security patches, the selective usage based on the severity to me, and then as a model. So initially it has to give it to me with a control to my system admin. If he say approves on certain scenario, it's getting implemented or applied automatically. We can give a complete, you know, automation as a complete control of that, of applying to that particular patches. Then I think is the time, which I see will take a year or so to happen. Then I think this is the way forward for automation in the information security to go forward. We have a ELK system, you know, Elastic Log Stash Kibana. So that is the database is getting generated every day. So we are able to record, and we are able to have a historical record of all the events getting generated, what are their trends and behavior patterns of the threat as well. So going forward, in 6 months to 1 year, I think we should be somewhere where the automation is a very, very, you know, achievable point.
For more updates from CXO TV, please like and subscribe to our channel.